Want to stand out in the competitive world of Amazon merch? Let me show you the secret to creating tumblers that sell like hotcakes. If you're creating tumblers on Amazon merch, you know how crowded the market can be. Today, I'm going to introduce you to the Productor Chrome extension, an incredible tool that helps you analyze trends, optimize your designs, and make your product stand out. By the end of this video, you'll know how to use this tool to create tumblers that grabs people's attention and sell. Top research design vault with 700 plus research niches back here. You get new research every single week with keywords, low competition, and the link for the design inspiration. And then on top of that, you get fresh ideas for these niches to help you create an original design. Now, the goal is to help you understand what is selling so you can create your own unique top selling design for this niche or idea or concept. My goal is to help you make sales, okay? And that is very important to me because if I do that for you, it's easier for me to create an amazing product like this right here. Now, it's only $10 a month and you can cancel at any time. You get access to all of the previous niches once you sign up to as well. And then I'll be releasing new niches every single week. All right, so I'm signed in to the back end of my Amazon Merch on Demand account. If you don't know what Amazon Merch on Demand is, it's you put a design on a product, okay? It goes live on Amazon.com. When it sells, Amazon prints and ships it to the customer for you and takes care of all the customer service and you collect the royalty, okay? I've been doing this for close to a little bit over 8 years now. And it's a really awesome opportunity. It's paid for a lot for me personally and created so much more opportunity for myself. Now, what we're using is the Productor for Merch by Amazon. This is a Chrome extension. Obviously, I have it installed already because it says remove from Chrome and it's right up here in the right-hand corner right there. Now, let's go ahead and take a design. So there's all these different products I can upload to, but for this example, we're going to go ahead and go over the tumbler. So I'm going to go ahead and upload a design. I have this cute little, it might be a beaver or it might be, trying to think what it is, groundhog. It is a cute design, right, for this example. And it has the hearts around it. You can see the glasses, which is pretty cool, okay? Now, when you upload it over here, there's a few different things. This little part pops up over here, okay? This is the Productor, and this pops up over here, and this is the Productor too as well, okay? There's a few things you can do with inside of this template. You can see, like, the print part of it, right? Little dotted red line. You want to keep it with inside of there. And then, obviously, we can, there's a few things we can duplicate. We can duplicate and download. You can resize to whatever you want, and then you can even just do a custom resize if you wanted to. And it will do all that for you. Now, one of the main things here is I want to bring the attention to is the front side image, back side image. Like this right here is really cool. And I think a lot of people, when it comes to this right here, you want to think about how you're going to be different and unique from the rest of your competition, right? And that is the main goal. So if you're creating a tumbler, okay, and you can do something where you can create a front and back design, okay, and be different from everyone else. Very powerful. Now, it could be easy, right? I can literally just duplicate the same one and just watch. Let me show you. So I hit the duplicate button. Okay, you can see that it made it bigger. You put the sizing and I have it front and back. Now, hit it again, and I can also download it too if I wanted to. So you can see how easy and simple that is. But now, let's go ahead and let's take this out right here. Remove the artwork. Let's go ahead and upload that same image. Okay, to the front, and then to the back, we want to put something like, let's say I have something right here. This is the Mondayest Thursday ever. So I want to put like a sarcastic, funny saying, but also want to be cute at the same time. And then I hit apply. So now what it's going to do, you see what it did right there? So I have a front design, okay? This one right here is created with AI too, by the way, pretty easy. And then I have a just a standard text design. Now, if you're unaware of AI, like you can obviously create different images, stuff like that over there. I personally use ChatGPT or Ideogram AI. And then as far as the design, creating the design, it's pretty simple. There's a few different things that you can use, like a merch informer. You can use like a Canva. You can use your Photoshop. There's a few different other design tools. A Photopea is a free web-based software too as well. All these other different platforms to help you create a text-based design or just an image like that, okay? So very simple, very easy to do. But let's go ahead and look at the preview of this so you can get an idea of what I'm talking about. Now you can see like it just brings it more to life and it's different, okay? which is powerful. So you see stuff like this. That's something like Valentine's Day is coming up, right? And then I'm creating like something with the hearts and creating an animal. Like literally just switching this out and then putting a different animal with some hearts around it is very simple, very easy to do. And you can do that and just keeping the same saying, or you can even switch out the saying, just trying to give you some inspiration, some different ideas on what you can do here. Okay. So it's pretty easy to use. But the thing is that front side image and that back side image and uploading it and applying it to the actual product, big game changer. Okay. Very simple, very easy to use with the Productor. And then also to download the actual image too. So if you wanted to upload it somewhere else, you can do that. But see exactly what it did. It downloaded it, right? It makes it so much easier, like so user-friendly to use. And that's right there is literally how you would create a front and back image with the Productor. And it's amazing. And then also too, there's different colors that you can apply back here with the Tumbler. So you can select your color. So if you don't want it on that white, you can use the silver. All right, you can use the silver. You see that? See the silver? I just want to make sure that the colors that you're applying the actual design to, it looks good on those colors. But literally, yeah, front back design. And that's how you create a Tumblr design that's going to stand out and be different from the rest of the competition. All right, so I did a little bit of research too as well. And what I did was typed in Valentine's Day, and I just used the stainless steel insulated Tumblr, which is unlisting automatically from right here. And then I came down and I clicked seller, put Amazon.com. So I will actually put this link down below in the description to give you an idea. But one of the holidays that are coming up is Valentine's Day, right? You're going to see like different sellers. Obviously, there are certain ones that you cannot do. So this is actual Disney. This is actual Disney. But looking at certain ones like, will you be my girlfriend? Just looking at different ideas and seeing what people are doing. I'm nuts for you. There's a few different cool ones, and you can just literally just go down this whole rabbit hole and see what's selling. So there's a ton of great ideas down here. My cat is my Valentine. And a lot of these designs too, this is a cool one. That's a cool one. A French bulldog. A lot of these designs too, Amazon actually, from our catalog on Amazon Merch On Demand, just went ahead and grabbed the actual design and put it onto Tumblr for us, which is really nice when they do something like that. When they release new products and they do that for us, it just saves so much time, right? Now, evergreen designs like this, even though you're leveraging Valentine's Day in the title, right? Something like this is like more of an evergreen. Okay. It has the hearts. It doesn't say nothing about Valentine's Day. It has a unicorn and a coffee mug, and it's on a tumbler. And it's a one-sided design, as you can see, because you're looking around, you can see it just one-sided. It's on a white colored tumbler. And then if we go down, we're going to see the BSR is 180K BSR, which is really good. So it's probably sound like every other day or every day. One cool thing too, I want to mention is the Merchant Farmer Tumblr check. And this will pop up if it's trademark. Usually, for the most part, if it's a single word like unicorn, that's okay. But usually it'll highlight the ones that I think is trademark. You can go ahead and click on it, and then you can dive into it a little bit more deeper. But unicorn or lover, something like that, you're okay. Unless it's like a Nike, obviously you cannot use that, or Disney, right? Single words like that are actually bigger brands, they'll get a rejection for that. But this is a cool way to check for trademarks, right? Now, next one, I steal hearts. Now, same thing with this one, right? Even though it has Valentine's Day in it, Akita. Right? It's a type of dog. So think about this, just leveraging different types of dogs, and you just getting ideas from this. Just, you can scale out. There's so many different dog breeds out there, right? And you can just switch that dog breed into a different dog, and then you have a completely different design. And this is on a black tumbler. It's in a black background, right? We come down like this, 146K BSR. Now, remember, the lower the BSR, the more sales velocity. So if it's, let's say, like 180K that we looked at over here with this unicorn, they may be selling 2 or 3, 4 times a day, right? And then for the most part, the higher, the less sales it has, the lower, the more sales it has. And it's probably a consistent seller. What you're looking for is a consistent seller, because we're leveraging the BSR to show that there's a demand in this niche and people are actually buying. Now, the next one right here, coffee lover gnomes Valentine's Day. You can see exactly what they did there. Just a basic image, right? Okay, which is really cool. Now, when it comes to this too, just keep in mind, like, how are you going to stand out from the rest of your competition? Are you going to create a double-sided where you can create two different images where you can put like a saying on the back end and then an actual graphic like this? It would be a good idea. So what I'm sharing with you in this video, just trying to think of different ideas to help you make money with your business and just stand out from the competition, because that's the main goal. So 266 KBSR, really nice. And then we have a unicorn, okay, with the little hearts. And then it has Valentine's Day, right? And then it's just one-sided design. Okay. Come down. Look at the BSR, 146K BSR. And nothing too crazy about that design. Pretty cool though. Love you like no otter. Okay.
see that one. Pretty cool. I think it's cute, especially for Valentine's Day. I feel like it's going to make more sales than what it's doing right now. It's at 1.8 million. It's a little bit higher BSR, but I thought it was a cool one, cool saying. Now, the world's most loved papa, okay? You're seeing that right there. Now, simple sayings like this, right? You can see this is a front and back design, which is pretty cool, but just want you to think about what else can you do to stand out from in your competition in a niche, right? So let's come down, look at the BSR. We have a result of 840, okay? 840K BSR. So just different ideas I wanted to share with you, different research ideas. You can see how tumblers are selling and how they're doing over here. I'll put this link down below in the description so you can actually see, and you come in here and see the different ideas that are selling over here. Now, one thing too, you can literally just switch this out. What I did with the Valentine's Days, you can just switch out this keyword to something else if you want, okay? You just literally delete that and put something else if you want, like Groundhog Day, okay? Hit search, and then boom, see that? There's different ideas right here. My favorite holiday. So you can see exactly what they're doing here with this, but switching out that and just putting a different keyword or a different holiday, anything like that, or a different dog breed or whatever it is, your hobby, baseball, football, basketball. And you can do that. And then you'll populate different results down here. You can see that Groundhog Day is obviously, there's BSRs, there's sales that are being made.
And that's it. By using the Productor Chrome extension, you'll gain access to powerful insights and tools that help you research trends, optimize your design for that listing, and create designs that truly stand out. Whether you're new to Amazon merch or looking to level up your game, this tool is a secret weapon for creating tumblers that sell. So start exploring, get creative, and let your design sell on Amazon. If you want more niche research ideas, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.